Today we're going to explore the emulator software of the CG50 graphing calculator. The fx-CG50 graphing calculator from Casio has an emulator, and you'll see that it looks like the handheld calculator. And when you open it, this is the default viewing. So you have the calculator and you have a keylog, which basically you can turn on or off or not have at all, where you can record the keystrokes that you are doing. This is really helpful when you are working with students, and I will be showing that in a moment. The calculator right here is the standard view. I did want to show you that in the emulator, depending on how you're presenting, if you are in a large room and you want to make this bigger on the screen, you can change the size. So view is where you would go to change the size of the calculator keyboard. That's this right here, or the calculator screen, which is the display screen. So I'm just going to show you right now, default is small. I'll show you what it looks like when it's normal. So this is considered normal. It's much bigger. The nice thing about both the keypad and the key window, the calculator screen, can be separated. So you could do them as two separate individual things. If you don't have a screen large enough to show them both in larger view, you can do them side by side. I can then, if I go back to view and change the calculator screen to normal, so now I have them side by side. So this is helpful if you need to have better viewing for some students. They want to really be able to see the keys. So your choice. You can make one big, one small. You can separate them however it works best for you. I'm going to put them back together, and I know it's gone off my screen here, and I'm going to set it back to small, so that you can see it on my screen. I like to keep it where it looks like the actual calculator because my students at the time would most likely be working on their own individual handheld, so I would want them to be matching what I'm doing. But again, that's your choice. Under view, we also have the toolbar, and you can, right now it's set to everything's on. You can see everything that is available. I can turn off views if I want to do that. So let's say I want to turn off the standard view. It gets rid of some of the options up here that I don't need to see anymore. So I'm going to bring that back just so that you can see those options. So what are these? This allows us to make a new paper, and that's this key log here. It lets us to create a folder and save things or open a folder that I already have, save my document. So if you think about it, the key logs are documents that record what you are doing. And they record the keystrokes, but let's go into key log. So notice my menu options here. We've gone into view and shown what that does. If you go into key log, right now it's in emulator key log mode where it's going to record my steps. If I change to editor mode, it means I can actually type in here. So questions, directions. So you think of this as a document. And so I can type in a direction to graph a specific equation. So that might be my directions. And now I can turn it back to the emulator and record the steps. So you can kind of go back and forth and create this document that you can then save and name and pass on to students, have them next to you. So that's one of the nice options with this. And this autoplay and step play and record are all related to this. And we're going to do a recording and show you what these two things do. So edit, again, pertains to these types of things. And so far, we haven't really done anything that we want to edit. So I'm going to go through how you record your steps. So I'm in my calculator. I am in the matrix. This looks just like the calculator that a student might have in their handheld. And if I want to record my steps, let's say I want to actually graph this and record how I did it so that my students can see how to do these steps, I'm going to turn on. So up here is the recording that relates to the keylog. So I'm going to turn on the recording by pushing the red button, or I could have gone over to keylog and hit record, either way. So I'm going to click the red button, and nothing is happening because I have to actually start doing things in the calculator. So you'll see what happens. So if I want to graph, I want to go to the graph menu. So I'm going to arrow down. So see how it's recording what I just did, hit execute. It opens my graph window. Now I'm going to enter my equation that I was given. So 2x variable plus 3. So it is recording everything that I'm doing, and I hit execute. And then I hit F6 to draw. So this is what the keylog will do for you. You can type in it when it's in editor mode, or you can record your steps. If you don't hit record, then it's not going to record anything on here. So you don't have to always have this on. So I'm going to stop the recording. And now that I have stopped the recording, if I go back to my menu and I click at the beginning of this, this is where those steps where you can autoplay or step play and do one step at a time, or I can autoplay through all of them. I want to make sure I'm at the beginning place that I started with this initial activity. So I was on run matrix when I started. So I'm going to hit autoplay and it's going to go through my steps for me. So it's doing the activity and going through this. It's like a movie playing. So that's an option that you can do. You can record something and students can actually see it. You can send this to students to play through themselves. So we've gone through file. File has to do with this, and also if I want to capture the screen. So right now I have this graph. Maybe I want to save it. Maybe I want to add it into a document that I'm creating, a worksheet, a test. So to capture visuals of things that you have done, there's two ways to do it. You can go over here if you're up in this software and click the camera button and it will capture the screen. This determines the size of the screen that you're going to capture. So default is small, so I'll show you what that looks like. So we're going to capture the screen. So there is this first capture and it's basically the size of the window that is currently there. If I had changed it to something larger and now I hit capture, notice it just is the same image larger. So it's up to you how you want to do this. So capture screen. Now I can save this also as a picture, as a JPEG, and use them in my documents. So that is, well, let's just leave it there then. Window is what do you want to see on. So notice I have three different things going on right now. And right now I'm highlighted this one, but maybe I want to click to that one. So that's what window is. And I can also change the formation. So right now they're tiled on top of each other. That's one way I could do it, but I can also move them individually, or I can horizontally tile them. So where they're kind of stacked that way. So that's kind of up to you. I personally like to go back to tiled because now I kind of can see and move them where I want. So you can basically create your own document space if you want to think of it that way. So if you want to have a graph next to the equation, next to the, so for example, I could go back and screen capture this equation. And now I have the equation next to the graph of it. So nice way to see multiple representations. So that's what all of this does. As far as tools, there's not a lot of different options. This is just the settings for your keylog in your spreadsheets. If you want to go into the spreadsheet, it talks about can you paste formulas, what language do you want to use if you're gonna convert them into an Excel. Okay, and then there's always of course the help manual if you need something specific. So that's the Emulator Basics. If you want to learn more about the calculator itself, how to do different menu options, we have different YouTube videos on that. So please look for those.